Okay, welcome back. So we're going to finish up the last part of this painting and do the body and the guns and everything else. Okay, so it looks like we're ready for the body now. Let's do it. Now, it is a black suit, so I think I pretty much need to leave this all black here. I might add some highlights and stuff later, but on the black line itself. Let's go to the suit. Okay, there we are. So here's my gray. Now, I'm going to darken it up a bit. And let's go ahead and bring some... I need to darken up more than that, I think. Yeah. Wrong brush. I'm going to select my soft round brush. And I'm going to kind of come out of my shadows that I drew. But really, I'm still thinking about the highlight, you know, coming from this direction. The light, my darks being on this side. All right, let's see. So I need to get definitely a little more precise as I get in there. I'm going to up my opacity to 5, to 50, that is. Question, is that dark enough? Is my question that I'm trying to answer right now. Back of the collar here would be dark. For some reason, I left it lighter on the boots. And I did it kind of intentionally, just thinking it would look different than the rest of the suit. Even though it's still black and all that, but we'll see if that pays off. All right, and this back leg's in shadow. Not shadow, sorry. It's kind of faded out a little bit, like it's further away. We'll just keep it like that and see what happens. Okay, let me go a little darker. So I'm pretty dark here. Try not to get quite to black, but even if I did, I have my opacity down, so it shouldn't paint straight to black unless I went over it a few times. I'm just trying to deepen some of these shadows here. So hitting that seam there. Well, there's a seam here too. Kind of got lost in the... whatchamacallit, threshold, that's what you call it. Okay, so I got this basically kind of roughed in here. Gloves, not a lot to see there, mostly black. Okay, let's hit it with some highlights. So I'm going to select the lightest color I can here. It can't be the lightest color, is it? Or is it? Okay, so I'm going to lighten it up. And I think I'm going to do this. I'm going to try this hard round pressure opacity again. Now, there's a ton of brushes, right? And you could even download more brushes or whatever, make brushes. But I kind of find that most of the work is done with like the same few brushes for me, you know? Lower my opacity. And the special brushes I kind of use once in a while. Okay, so I'm trying to hit some highlights here. These edges a little bit. Undo that a little bit. I want to do that a little more subtly. Or not so subtly. Let's see. Lift off with the brush. Okay. Highlight here, that holster. This should be mostly dark, I think, this holster. Let me go back to my darker color. Paint this in. All right. Got it kind of shaded there. All right, moving back to the guns. Go to details. So let's hit it with some shadows. So I'm going to go to this red thing first. And I think I want to make it look kind of like a jewel, I guess. So with some more extreme highlights. Guess. Let's go. So I'm going to pick the original red there. And I'm going to bring it a little more towards the orange, which sometimes helps when shading red, or highlighting red, sorry. Shading is the wrong word. Or else, I don't know, the pink kind of just feels a little too desaturated, I guess, when I've shaded with that. Okay, so I'm going to make it brighter now, a little more yellow. Okay, let's see if I can go really close to white here. Let's see how that looks. Okay, I think I missed a little bit over here. That kind of needs a little something there. Hit the original color back in. I just selected it right from the picture itself. Okay, well, we'll live with that for now. Okay, just gonna keep moving. I'm gonna do these armbands, these yellow armbands. And I'm going to shade them, because they're yellow, with orange. If you add straight black to yellow, you get kind of like a gross, almost greenish looking color. And orange or brown definitely seems to work better for shading yellow in most instances. Just going a little darker here. Okay, so I got my original yellow color. Actually, let me go get this orange again. I'm going to see if I can hit. I got the same brush going here, this hard round brush, which is giving me the ability to kind of hit these little thin areas. But now I want to hit thin areas again with a highlight. So let me lighten up the yellow. Okay, yeah, that'll work. All right, got some guns here. So I got my bluish gray. I'm gonna go for the dark here first. I usually go shade first, then highlights. And that's just the way I learned a long time ago from a comic book painter. I watched tutorials from him a long time ago. Back when you had to buy tutorials, and they came on CDs, that ancient world before videos could be so easily streamed. I don't even know. I mean, definitely now everything's on YouTube, but I don't remember what YouTube was back then, or how big it was, or even if it was a thing. Might have been, just not as big, I don't know. But I had to buy them. His name's escaping me right now. But he was a really good comic book colorist. Okay, let's see here. So I've still got my hard round. I'm going to switch it back to the soft. Kind of hit that a little bit. I'm actually hitting it on the top. And it's kind of a little thing, metal, that kind of is a quick way to make it look cool. Just almost highlight it the opposite, kind of. Okay, so let's go ahead and hit now the original color, select it, and then make a highlight of it. And I'm going to hit some highlights, do a little one there. I'm going to go brighter. Now as I go brighter, I'm going to do this. I'm going to switch back to my hard round opacity so I can kind of get some more precise little highlight hits. Try and keep it looking metallic if I can. Okay, now for over here. Okay, oh, look at me, forgetting the straps. Strapping things. This won't take much, because they're not really supposed to be metal or anything. I just colored them different just so they look different, just to kind of get a little something different going in here. Okay, let's see, let's take a look now. All right, not too bad. Okay, we've got everything pretty much kind of generally colored here. So there's a few more things to do. And you can kind of keep taking this as far as you want. But we won't take it too far just to keep this kind of simple and more on the beginner stage. Okay, look, I got to undo that. I got to fix this little stray mark that's bothering me. Okay, I put it back on. Lock it again. And one thing I didn't do was this. I forgot to color these. I didn't forget. I kind of put it off and then I forgot. So I'm going to go ahead and select this orange color here and the guns as well. I didn't color any of those things. So I'm going to make this darker, a little more red maybe a little darker like that. And now let's go ahead and, okay, I'm going to use a hard pressure. That's fine. That is definitely too light. Let's see how that looks. Too light as well. Okay, now I can go back in with black. Kind of fix it if I went too far, which I for sure did over here. Okay, let's check out this metal stuff. So I'm going to select this color here. Go ahead and darken it up a bit, saturate it a little more. And let me go ahead and hit black again. Kind of touch it up here where it kind of went quickly. Now I can use X because I have them both loaded. Okay. X again. I'm going to darken it just a little bit more. And let's see what this gun looks like if I give it some change the color of its outline. A little bigger there. Okay. There we go. Let's see, zoom out a little bit. Okay, so that looks pretty good. Oh, check this out. Forgot about this. I'm gonna pick the darkest red here. Darken it up a little more. Outline it. Okay, there we go. There we go. Again, I can use black to touch it up if I want to. I'm going to leave the inside black. I think that's the way it should look. Looking around, make sure to miss anything else. Okay, these little straps, but I don't want them to look metallic or anything. So I'm going to keep them like that. Okay, so I'm going to make a new layer. I'm going to call it FX, short for effects. And we're going to go ahead and make some shines now and paint on top of all the layers. So I'm going to select this inside color here. Make sure I drop my opacity down back to around 30 something. And I want to kind of build a little glow here. And I'm using my soft round pressure opacity brush. Okay, there we go. Let's see, a little bit on this side as well. And anything that you think kind of calls for a little bit of a shine might work. So let's try the lips. We could make them look a little bit glossy if we wanted to. It's maybe a little overkill, but let's see. Okay, I think that's all right. Okay, now her suit could be all shiny. We'll see how that goes. We'll see. If you make everything shiny, then nothing's shiny. So you got to be careful. So I'll do a little bit on this little Black Widow symbol here. And then maybe a little bit on these metal pieces. A little brighter than the color. And it's definitely easy to go overkill on this kind of effect. But if you want to make something stand out as shiny or give it a different kind of look, you know, this is a good way to do it. So it's a little much there. And it's easy to go overkill and do it in too many places. Because again, if you make everything shiny, then nothing's shiny, you know. In order for something to look shiny, for this to communicate shine, other things can't be all shiny. If you know what I'm saying. Too much there. Don't like it right there. Okay, let's take a look. I might have gone a little too much over here, so I'm going to actually knock it back a little bit with my eraser. And let's make sure I've got the soft brush. And let's make it big. And I want the opacity kind of low, because I just want to knock it back. I don't want to take it all off. So I'm hitting it kind of big. Just knocking it back a bit, trying to erase it evenly. Okay, there we go. All right, now we got a little effects layer going. And the last thing we need now is something called reflected light. And this I could have done earlier, but let's do it anyways. So I'm gonna start with the skin. And reflected light is light that bounces past our subject and bounces back and hits it from another source. Usually, the sky can provide that kind of bluish light. Another light source could provide reflected light. To make it look different, even though our background's kind of brownish, I'm going to give it a little bit of a blue tint to it. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and select a blue, but I got to desaturate it a lot, so it's almost gray. Okay, Okay, let's see how this looks. So I'm on the skin layer. And, you know, a lot of times this hard round pressure opacity brush is pretty nice for this reason. But I'm on the eraser. I need to go to the brush. Keep my opacity kind of low. And I just want to think about kind of light kind of hitting our subject from the other side. Go ahead and save this right now before I do this. Okay, so I'm going to hit kind of, I'm imagining light coming from the back and lighting up the backside of things. So I can say maybe a little bit might hit her on the nose, a little might hit under there, under the chin. You know, and it's cartoony, so I'm going to keep it kind of easy. And that's probably good for the skin there, at least. Let's see the fingers. Kind of too small to even get anything in there, unfortunately. But let's try the hair now. Okay, so on the back side of the hair, so I'm imagining kind of light kind of hitting the back. Lighten up the bottoms, some of these shapes here. Wrong way. There we go. That's the way I want it. Maybe under here a bit. Just kind of cooling down the colors a bit. Maybe the back there a little bit. As this curls out. It can be a whole area, it can be kind of an edge, it can be both. Okay. Now, let's get to the suit. This should be interesting here. And I want this to actually be a little bluer. So let's see here. Again, imagining things facing the back. Okay, maybe this whole leg down here, actually. So it's kind of on the other side of the shadow. Kind of tricky to do with this really dark lighting that I gave it, you know, because the suit's really black. Okay, it's a little something there, a little something. And let's see. I don't know how these armbands are going to look with cool down a little bit because they're so orange. I think it looks okay. Guns are already blue, so I kind of can't really do it too well with them. But yeah, we'll let them be as they are. Okay, let's take a look now. Okay, so I think that'll do it. So we got a definitely good little thing going. It's definitely on the easy end of painting and painting underneath our drawing. And that's okay. It's a good place to start. And hopefully it's a good refresher if you haven't painted in a while in Photoshop or if you're new to it. Hopefully it's a good place to start. There's definitely more techniques you can use and you can obviously render this even further. I tried to keep it on the simple end to get people started in Photoshop. I hope you guys got a good painting yourself. And I'll see you on the next video.